Today, we are going to tear down the charger that comes with the Vivo X200 and S20 series. It utilizes GaN technology, featuring a maximum output power of 90 watts. Although the output port is USB-A, it supports charging protocols such as QC and UFCS. The Vivo logo is printed on the front of the box. The specs info is printed on the back. The sticker on the bottom displays information such as the model, color, and manufacturing date. The box contains the charger, cable, and some documents. The USB-A to USB-C cable supports a current of up to 8.5 amps. The length is about 96.5 centimeters. The charger's case is made of flame-retardant PC material. The input end is also printed with spec info. Model V9082L01CN. It is equipped with fixed prongs. The output port is a single USB-A. The length is about 61.01 millimeters. The width is about 52.47 millimeters. The thickness is about 28.85 millimeters. It is significantly smaller than the Apple 96 watts charger. That's how big it is in the hand. The weight is about 104 grams. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it supports UFCS, QC 2.0, and DCP protocols. It supports a UFCS voltage range of 5 to 11 volts at 4 amps. Using it to charge the Vivo X200 Pro, the power is about 72 watts. Next, let's take it apart to see its internal components and structure. Cut open the input end case. The wires are cold pressed and soldered to terminals. A sponge is attached to the top of the capacitors. A plastic isolation plate is placed between the primary and secondary sides. The USB-C socket is reinforced with a plastic housing, and a metal heatsink is also installed to dissipate heat from the synchronous rectifier. The gaps are filled with potting compound. The back is covered with a plastic plate and a metal heatsink. Remove the metal heatsink. Part of the back is also filled with potting compound for reinforcement. Remove the potting compound. Fuse, common mode choke, electrolytic capacitor, and transformer are present on the front of the module. There are primary MOSFET, optocoupler, and synchronous rectifier controller on the back. The time delay fuse is from BetterFuse. 3.15 amps 250 volts. The safety X2 capacitor is from HJC. 0.47 microfarad. It uses four GR3 MBF rectifiers configured as a bridge rectifier. These two electrolytic capacitors are from Caution. 400 volts 27 microfarad. The I-shaped inductor is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The primary master control chip is from SouthChip. The primary MOSFET is from InnoScience. It is a 700 volt rated enhancement mode GaN FET, with a device voltage rating of 700 volts and a transient voltage rating of 800 volts. It has an on resistance of 350 milliohms and adopts the TO252 package. The capacitor that powers the master control chip is from Caution. 50 volts 4.7 microfarad. The Evolike EL1019 optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The synchronous rectifier controller is from SouthChip. The synchronous rectifier is from Pingwei and adopts the DFN 5x6 package. 60 volts 5 milliohms. This solid capacitor is from Caution. 16 volts 680 microfarad. This is the other solid capacitor. 16 volts 470 microfarad. The protocol chip is from Injoinic. It is an integrated fast charging protocol control IC designed for USB ports, supporting multiple fast charging protocols. The output V-bus MOSFET is from Pingwei, marked with 050N03HL. Here is the component list of the Vivo 90W flash charge GaN charger for your convenience. It features a classic design and comes with a cable that supports a current of 8.5 amps. It offers overvoltage and overcurrent protections. After taking it apart, we found that the components like capacitors and connectors are reinforced, and the synchronous rectifier is equipped with a dedicated heatsink for cooling. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.